There is no self-righteousness in Jesus. He pleads with the Father because He suffered what sinners have gone through without sinning. In the end, that's the holiness of Jesus. A life totally given to do the will of God, and a life of total intercession. Intercession for erring sinners. Ako aaminin ko sa inyo, ho, minsan kapag mayroong pari na parang mahirap pakisamahan, a part of you that does not want to suffer, no? Gusto mo na lang tirisin. O kaya, nasunin ko kaya. Joke lang yun, sister, ha? Kayo, ha? Baka isuplong nyo ako, ha? Metaphor lang yan. Parang, to protect yourself from burdens and suffering, mawala na sana. Pero iba ho yung when you realize your own weaknesses, when you admit that you are also weak and sinful, and then you start suffering, not only because you have to handle this personality, but you suffer with Him. And then you really pray. You pray for the person by name. Many times a day, you pray, you mention His name. You intercede for the Father. But you suffer, and you hope that in that suffering, you are transformed. You are made perfect somehow in compassion and in closeness to God. So it is not an external ritual performance. For Jesus, the offering, the sacrifice is personal, His body, His blood, and the interior transformation of the heart, wounded heart, but because of that wound, open to God, open to neighbors, open to other wounded hearts. And in this heart of Jesus is fulfilled the prophecy in Ezekiel, the promise of a new heart, the heart where the law of God will be imprinted, the heart where the covenant will be fulfilled. And this heart is at our disposal. Enter this heart. We can enter that heart because that heart was offered for us. My body for you, my blood for you. So come to the throne of mercy. Come, that's the invitation in Hebrews. Do not be afraid. Come, you have a throne of mercy in the very heart of Jesus, our priest. And you will find solace. You will find healing. Which brings me to the third and last point. Sharing in the one priesthood of Christ. This priesthood of Christ coming from His person, His heart, His body, His blood, His spirit, open to God and open to neighbor. He is the source of a new dynamism. And this dynamism of life, of holiness, is available to us. Jesus sets in motion a powerful movement of holiness, of solidarity, of reconciliation, of communion, abolishing all barriers and separation, reuniting people among themselves as brothers and sisters in compassion, and reuniting sinful humanity, wretched humanity, with the holy God. In Jesus, a new dynamism is being spread all over the world. Have no fear. The distant God wants to come near. Do not run away from the throne of mercy. Come. This is the dynamism that Jesus' priesthood wants to share with us and to start as a movement of life, hopefully with Christians, the baptized, as signs and models. Sharing in the priesthood of Christ is sharing in His holiness. Availability to do God's will and existence. Potential solidarity with neighbors, especially the wounded and those who have committed mistakes in life. The letter to the Hebrews, chapter 13, gives a very concrete description of a lifestyle that shares in the priesthood of Christ. Let mutual love continue. Do not neglect hospitality, for through it some have unknowingly entertained angels. Be mindful of prisoners, as if sharing their imprisonment, and of the ill-treated as of yourselves, for you also are in the body. Let marriage be honored among all, and the marriage bed be kept undefiled, for God will judge the immoral and adulterers. Let your life be free from love of money, but be content with what you have. For He has said, I will never forsake you or abandon you. Thus we may say with confidence, the Lord is my helper, and I will not be afraid. What can anyone do to me? The bodies of the animals whose blood the high priest brings into the sanctuary as a sin offering are burned outside the camp. Therefore, Jesus also suffered outside the gate. His death was considered by the Levitical priesthood not as consecration, but as a desecration. That's why He was crucified outside the gate. But the letter to the Hebrews says, let us then go to Him outside the camp, hearing the reproach, bearing the reproach that He bore. bear the insults that Jesus bore and be perfected like Him. Through Him, let us continually offer God a sacrifice of praise. That is, the fruit of lips that confess His name. Do not neglect to do good and to share what you have. God is pleased by sacrifices of that kind. We are outside ritual. We are on the level of life and the quality of person. We are not even talking here about ordination. We are not even talking here about vowed life. We are talking about something fundamental. Baptism. Kaya nung rector po ako ng seminaryo, kapag may seminarista na pagdating nung last year of formation, biglang nagiging holy. Sabi ko, too late, baby. Dapat nagpaka-holy ka mula nung bininyagang ka na. Hindi tayo nagpapaka-holy dahil ordained. Di tayo nagpapaka-holy kasi madre o brother or what. Nagpapaka-holy tayo dahil bininyagan. And that's where we all share in the priesthood of Christ. Whether ordained, consecrated with the vowed life, lay people, dyan tayo sama-sama. At minsan aminin natin that holiness of life we see among simple mothers and fathers, the simple janitors, the simple cleaner in the canteen, the laundry woman who suffers in order to send her child to school. That's why we need to learn from Christ and the many witnesses, according to the letter to the Hebrews, the many witnesses of faith and holiness. And as we celebrate our calling to be holy as baptized and in ordained life, ministry, and in consecrated life, we also admit that we have to be inspired by the dynamism of holiness that many unsung heroes of the faith manifest to us. And I close with a paraphrase of the letter to the Hebrews in Romans 12. There is a consistency. Romans 12. I urge you, therefore, brothers and sisters, by the mercies of God, to offer your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and pleasing to God, your spiritual worship. Do not conform yourselves to this age, but be transformed by the renewal of your mind, that you may discern what is the will of God, what is good and pleasing and perfect. Love, let love be sincere. Hate what is evil. Hold on to what is good. Love one another with mutual affection. Anticipate one another in showing honor. Do not grow slack in zeal. Be fervent in spirit. Serve the Lord. Rejoice in hope. Endure in affliction. Persevere in prayer. contribute to the needs of the holy ones, exercise hospitality. Bless those who persecute you. Bless and do not curse them. Rejoice with those who rejoice. Weep with those who weep. Have the same regard for one another. Do not be haughty, but associate with the lowly. Do not be wise in your own estimation. Do not repay anyone evil for evil. Be concerned for what is noble in the sight of all. If possible, on your part, live at peace with all. Beloved, do not look for revenge, but leave room for the wrath of God. For it is written, "Vengeance is mine, I will repay," says the Lord. Rather, if your enemy is hungry, feed him. If he is thirsty, give him something to drink. For by so doing, you will heap burning coals upon his head. Do not be conquered by evil, but conquer evil with good. This is the priesthood of Christ in daily life. Let us pause and let us continue the atmosphere of recollectedness. If there are other points in the letter to the Hebrews and other biblical passages that appeal to you regarding the priesthood of Christ, feel free to go into those texts.